Amanda. Welcome again. And we're going to talk about how SEAL Kit works. And then after this, it's really cool, we're going to see some demos about using the SEAL Kit for those of you who haven't used it before. So get all your questions going on right now while we're just learning about it. And then once you see it, you can get all your questions out and learn some more. So if I will talk about semiconductors, we learned about semiconductors. And here's that diagram again. We have the lower energy level where the electrons are living. And then we have that higher energy level and that gap in between. And electrons can be excited from the lower energy level to the higher energy level. And at this higher energy level, they can move around and conduct electricity. So how do we get them up to that higher energy level? We excite them with light. So in photoactive semiconductors, light, here's our lightning bolt, comes in and it helps the electron jump up to that higher energy level. And in that higher energy level, the electrons can move around. And this is important to us because the flow of electrons is electricity. And that's what we want to do. We want to take the sun energy, the light energy, and convert it to electricity. So if we get a flow from this, where they're in this higher energy level, we can have our light energy converted to electrical energy. And we use the SEAL Kit to measure how well our semiconductors, which we showed, this is the diagram of our semiconductor energy levels. We use the SEAL Kit to see how well we can change that light energy to electrical energy. So that's called photoactivity. How well is it absorbing that light and changing it into electricity? And with the SEAL Kit, we have this technique called photoelectrochemistry. It uses this technique called photoelectrochemistry. What is photoelectrochemistry? We can break that down. This word down has photo in it. So we think about photon, we think about light, like photography deals with light and capturing what we see. And then we have electrochemistry. So electro is like electrons, electricity, and then chemistry. Chemistry is like our reactions, our molecules, our ions doing things. And we can use our SEAL Kit to measure how well our semiconductors change light energy into electrical energy. So in our diagram here, our semiconductors are spotted on this plate. And we'll look at some of these spotted plates later. But for those of you who have done this already, you know how spotting plates work. And then how do we have photoelectrochemistry to detect our change from light energy to electrical energy? Well, we need the photo part, we need the light part. So our semiconductors are sitting here on this light box, and the light box turns on and it excites the semiconductor on our plate. And then we saw that the semiconductor with the light does something with the electrons. It makes the electrons excited, and we can then do our electrical measurement because we have all these wires attached to our cell. And we have a complete circuit in electricity. We can have a flow of electricity. We have a complete circuit, we can have a flow of electricity. So where's our circuit here? Here's our semiconductor cell going to a wire, going to this potentiostat, and then we have another wire coming out and going back into our cell with this graphite rod, and then it's all connected with our sodium hydroxide solution. So that's how our flow of electrons is going. That's how our electricity is moving. And then the chemistry part happens in our cell with our sodium hydroxide and our water, and we're going to split water. And the rest of this part, this potentiostat, helps us detect the flow of electrons. So it helps us see how much current is flowing. And we can get that output through our computer right here because it's attached to the computer as well. And then it's also attached to this multimeter to help give us a relative measurement. So let's go more deeply into the electrochemistry. part. Let's look at our cell right now. So electrochemistry. What reaction are we doing? The water splitting reaction. Awesome. Where are we doing it? We're doing it in this cell right here. I took out the plate with our semiconductors right now, just for simplicity. So now we just have two things like graphite rods. Say we have two graphite rods. But we're doing the water splitting reaction. Why are we doing the water splitting reaction?
Hydrogen.
We want to get hydrogen. So how do we split water? H2O. We split it up into hydrogen and oxygen. And we want to use the hydrogen to fuel, solar fuel. And we're doing this with the sunlight. So in our full reaction above, we have H2O, and it breaks down into hydrogen and oxygen. And in our electrical chemical cell, actually, it's broken down into half reactions. So the full thing that the cell is doing is giving us hydrogen and oxygen. But at each of these terminals, we're actually doing half reactions. And these are the half reactions below, where we have electrons coming in and helping do a reaction, as well as electrons going out and replacing the electrons that came in. So there's something where the wires are behind the board that's going on. Maybe it's powering our light bulb or something like that. Or it's a battery, because we have electrons flowing with batteries, and because we don't have our semiconductor right here, we don't have the light energy, we don't really have the energy to split water. So that would be a battery instead. But how about we'll go through these half reactions. Which half reaction do you think is happening, the top one, at which place? Do you think it's happening here or here? So this is one, this is two. The first half reaction, who thinks it's happening at place one? Show of hands. And then can I call on someone? How come? How about you? Going on. We learned in our last slide we need the electrons to flow in order to get our full reaction, in order to water split. So we have our light, it's exciting electron, the electron's moving around, it can move through our circuit here, and then we can split water just in the same way at those two terminals that we saw on our previous cell. The only difference is now we have a semiconductor, and if we didn't have the light, then we couldn't move that electron around. So we can also say that the more electrons we have moving around, the more reactions we can have happening, and the greater photoactivity our semiconductor we can measure. So when we measure this with our SEAL kit, we'll get this output right here for our different spots on our semiconductor plate. Each of those blocks represents a different spot. And the computer will do that for you. You don't have to keep track of that, which is awesome. But because we have our electrochemical cell connected to our potentiostat, it's measuring how many electrons are flowing. This is also called a current integrator, by the way. You can use it as a current integrator of potentiostat. And if you think about it being a current integrator, current is flowing through, and an integration means adding up all the pieces. So it's adding up all of the current. And through that, it outputs it on the computer, and we get this awesome plot. Any questions with that? And then finally, we have a twist ending. What does that mean? We saw that if we can provide electrons, then we can see current. But electrons aren't always happening because of light excitation and electrons moving around here. It's not always happening. What else can happen that can give us electrons? If we were degrading our semiconductor, then electrons can come from different reactions like that. So if we took apart our semiconductor and it had an electron and then the semiconductor turned into what it was before, like a metal salt, if it dissolved the semiconductor in your sodium hydroxide solution, we're still getting electrons out from the semiconductor, and this reaction can still flow, and you'll still detect electrons with your current integrator, with your potentiostat, and you'll see, oh man, photoactivity is so awesome. But then when you take out your plate from solution, what happened to our spots? They're all gone. So you gotta be careful when you're doing these reactions. Sometimes you won't always have your semiconductor being really great. Sometimes it'll just fall apart into electrons and something else. So be wary and watch your semiconductors. And now I think we'll start on setting up the demos if there are any more questions.